Madam, will you please explain what is saddle point?
Saddle point means there is no maxima, no minima. Point of inflection is also known as saddle point. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
3x square plus 3y square plus 24. This is our function. Now, I know that at 0, 0, I got relative minima. So I will substitute the value 0, 0 here. So I will get 24 because this is the value at 0, 0. Am I right? Now, if I put minus 2, 0, this will be minus 8 plus 0 means plus 12 minus 2, 0. This is 3 into 4 and plus 24. So this will give me 28. So what is my maximum value? Maximum value is 28 and minimum value is 24. The other two points are saddle point, but we can still find the value of function at those saddle point. And this is 220 by 9 and this is 256 by 9. So this is when the function is a function of two variable and you need to decide a maxima or a minima, or you need to find the optimal solution of it. And this is a method. Next point here, I have explained you what is global maxima minima also. What is concave and convex set. Concave set means this f of lambda x1 plus 1 minus lambda x2 is greater than or equal to f of x1 into lambda plus 1 minus lambda into f of x2. In short, I will give you, without even looking at here or there, you can think about this function. Like if you say that, observe it. At this any point here, the tangent is parallel to x-axis. Suppose this is that point. Tangent is parallel to x-axis. Now here, this tangent makes positive angle. If I draw a tangent at this point, it makes negative angle. Okay, so here, if I talk about the angle, this angle is positive, then it becomes zero, and then tan theta, slope. You can talk about tan theta. Slope of this line. The slope of the line, that means dy by dx. In general, so slope of the line means dy by dx. So this slope is positive. It becomes zero here. This is positive. This becomes zero and this is negative. So what do I talk about this tan theta? It decreases. Am I right? As x increases. Is that correct? Do you understand it? If I move from, yes, from left to right, x increases. This is the x-axis. If I move from left to right, x increases. But this tan theta means dy by dx, it decreases. Is that correct? One variable decreases, one variable increases. So the second sign of the second order derivative, dou square f by dou x square, this is negative. If both are increasing, then this is positive. Do you get it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And
yes, ma'am.
When the second order derivative is negative, the function is concave. And if the second order derivative is positive, the function is convex. This is explained in the next slide. This is convex function. Now here, if you look at this. If you have a function of one variable, say z is equal to f of x, it is convex. Oh, I made a mistake. This is greater than zero. If it is convex, this is greater than zero. And if it is concave, then the sign is less than zero. Do you get it?
Yes,
this dou square z by dou x square is greater than zero if the function is convex, and it is less than zero if the function is concave. Okay, do you observe it? I have corrected it also. Now, if there is a function of two variables, f of x, y. Now, if then how do we decide concave and convex? if this Hessian matrix is positive, Hessian matrix is positive, it less greater than or equal to 0, then it is convex. If it is just greater than 0, we call it as a strictly convex. Greater than or equal to and just greater than 0. Similarly, these derivatives, dou square z by dou x square and dou square z by dou y square, both are positive. If both are positive and Hessian matrix is also positive, then the function is convex. And if it is just greater than 0, strictly positive, then the function is strictly convex. Similarly, if the values are negative or less than or equal to negative, the function is concave or it is strictly concave. This is regarding the second function of two variables. But if you talk about the function of many variables, then how do we decide whether the function is concave or convex? You know, a big Hessian matrix. Hessian matrix is a matrix of order second order derivatives. Okay. Now, if you calculate the principal minors of those matrices, principal minors means determinant of HK, you can say. Whether HK, it is a minor of order K. Minor of order K means all the elements of K rows and K columns, first K rows and K columns. If this is strictly greater than 0 for all values of K, then the function is convex, right? If this Hessian matrix HK is greater than 0, means minor of this matrix, for all values of K, then this is convex. If it is greater than or equal to 0, it will be convex. And if it is strictly greater than 0, it will be strictly convex, right? These are two parameters. So I can write here the condition HK is greater than or equal to 0 for all K. And here determinant HK is strictly greater than 0 for all K. So this is strictly convex. And what about concave? For concave, this determinant HK is less than or equal to 0. And here determinant HK is strictly less than 0 for all values of K. Then we call it as a concave or a convex function. If you want to find the, if you want to solve some example to identify whether the function is concave or convex, you can take one example. Shall I give it to you? If you want, I can give you one example to identify whether the function is concave or convex. Shall I give you the example?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. I'm giving just a minute. Give me 1 minute. Determine whether the function is convex or concave. I will give you the function of only two variables. Otherwise, it would be very lengthy. You can take it 3x plus 2x square. Shall I write here? Function, you can say f is equal to 3x plus 2x square plus 4y plus y square minus 2xy. Can you check whether it is concave or convex? Can you check whether this is concave or convex? Okay, what is the function? F is equal to 3x plus 2x square plus 4y plus y square minus 2xy. This is a function. So what you will do, you will find dou f by dou x. That is equal to 3 plus 4x minus 2y. Dou f by dou y is equal to 4 plus 2y minus 2x. Now if you solve these two equations equal to 0, so you will get values of x and y. So what do you write? 4x plus 2y. Oh, sorry. It is 4x minus 2y. Minus 2y plus 3 equal to 0. And second equation is minus 2x plus 2y plus 4 equal to 0. So this, if you solve it, you will get 2x is equal to 7. So x is equal to 7 by 2. And y is equal to 3 by 2. Am I right?
Ma'am, x will be minus 7 by 2.
Yeah, yeah, minus 7 by 2. You are, oh, sorry, I made a mistake. This is minus 7 by 2. So this will be, y will be wrong then.
It's 3.
Is it 3? No. 4. This is minus 7 into minus 7. Yeah, yeah, it is 3 by 2. This is correct. 3 by 2 is right. How can it be right? Three by two. Check it once again. How can y be 3 by 2 then? If I said, so add it, this is 2x plus 7 equal to 0. So x is minus 7 by 2. So it is 3 plus.
Y is minus 11 by 2.
Minus 11 by 2, that's what.
Yes, ma'am, minus 11 by 2.
Y is equal to minus 11 by 2. So we got x and y. So now we will calculate dou square f by dou x square. That is equal to 4 dou square f by dou y square. That is equal to 2 and dou square f by dou x dou y. That is equal to minus 2 here also, and dou square f by dou y dou x. This is also equal to minus 2. So your Hessian matrix will become 4 minus 2 minus 2 and 2. You know this is symmetric. This is symmetric, so we don't need to do anything. What is its first minor? H1 is 4 and that is equal to 4. Second minor is a matrix itself, means a determinant. 4 minus 2 minus 2 and 2. So this will give you 8 minus 4 is 4. This is positive. These two matrices are positive, strictly positive. These two derivatives are strictly positive. So what is this matter? This particular function, this f is a convex function. I would say it's strictly convex. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
It is strictly convex. Since it is strictly convex, we know the values. This is x equal to minus 7/2 and y is equal to minus 11/2. This gives us the optimal solution and you will get minima here. Am I right? This function will give you minimum value, not maximum. Correct? So you can calculate the value of f at this point. So that is a minimum value. So here f will be 3 into minus 7/2 plus 2 into 49/4 plus 4 into minus 11/2 plus 121/4 minus 2 into minus 77/4. So you can easily add it. Minus 21 plus 14 in 9 into 2 is 94. Okay, you can make it 2 or 4 everywhere. This is 6 into 7, 42 minus 503/4. I may be right, may be wrong, just you can calculate it. This is the value of this particular function. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you know how to decide convex and concave functions. So we'll go ahead with second point, that is multivariate optimization with equality constraint. I have solved one or two examples here so that you will understand how to find the optimum value of the function when the variables are more than two variables. And particularly from this particular example, maybe you can see this from where we have started this Hessian matrix and all. From here itself, multivariate optimization with no constraint, single variable. If you observe this particular question right in the beginning, single variable optimization, you will see that the optimum function, the function, objective function is non-linear in nature. Can you observe it? This objective function fx, it is non-linear in nature. For linear function, you know, there are two methods, graphical method, simplex method. There might be some more, but we have studied two methods, graphical and simplex, for a linear function. Linear programming problem. Now this is non-linear programming, particularly this is of a single variable. Then we have gone ahead, single variable with no constraint, correct? And then multivariable with no constraint. This is multivariable with no constraint. We have seen one example here. This is that example, multivariable with no constraint. Now we'll proceed further. For multivariable with constraint, right? Multivariable with equality constraint. Now how to solve it? Multivariable nonlinear. These are all nonlinear problems. So how to do it? Now we consider the optimization of a continuous function. Say maximize fx subject to this condition dx equal to 0. What is this x? X means a vector x1, x2, x3, xn. Means here instead of fx, I can write it as fx1, x2, x3, x4 and xn. In this way. Okay. This way I can write. X4 up to xn. This is that variable. Now here, this is j is equal to 1 to m. Now here the variables are n, but the constraints are m, and m is less than n. Okay, m is less than n. Means I will explain you with this example. Then how to find a solution of this optimization problem. For example, let us consider the function. What is this example? This example says a box is inscribed in a sphere. This is a sphere of radius 1 and a box is inscribed in a sphere of this type. And our aim is to find the size of this box for maximum volume. Means the volume is to be maximized and we need to find the size of the box. Means we need to find length, width and height of the box. So let us assume that XYZ is a center, and then you know that when XYZ is a center, the sides of the box will be 2X, 2Y and 2Z. Then the volume of the box will be 2X into 2Y into 2Z. This is the volume of the box, L into B into H. So that is 8XYZ. So this is a function. We need to maximize this function. What is our concept? Our concept is to maximize this volume V. Now, since the box is inscribed in a circle, these points X, Y, Z will lie, these 2X, 2Y, 2Z vertices. Vertices of this box will lie on the circumference or on the sphere. So because of that, this X, Y, Z will satisfy the particularly the constraint X square plus Y square plus Z square is equal to 1. I don't know whether I'll be able to draw the correct picture, but I will try my level best. Assume that this is a sphere and this will be a box. This is a center. So this is also a radius. So this XYZ will lie on the coordinates of this center are X, Y, and Z. So this XYZ will lie on a sphere. So it satisfies this constraint. And once you know that it satisfies this constraint, that means if I simplify it, I will get Z is equal to 1 minus X square minus Y square, and it's a square root raised to half. So this function fxyz, this is a function of three variable, can be converted with the help of this constraint as a function of two variable. 8xy into 1 minus x square minus y square raised to half. And that needs to be maximized. So as usual, when I know that maximization, this is a problem of maximization, I will use a necessary condition, dou f by dou x and dou f by dou y equal to 0. If I equate these two derivatives to 0, I will get x is equal to y is equal to z, which is equal to 1 upon root 3. Because if I simplify this, it's a little lengthy explanation. I know that my function f is my function f is equal to f is equal to 8xy into under root of 1 minus x square minus y square. This is my function. So if I have to differentiate with respect to x, we need to apply a product rule. And that is, I hope you remember product rule, 8y into under root 1 minus x square minus y square into the derivative of x is 1. And then another way is 8xy. Second term will be 8xy. These are the derivatives 8xy into 8xy into the derivative of root is 1 upon 2 root 1 minus x square minus, minus y square into minus 2x. So this 2 will cancel and you will get minus 8x square y upon under root 1 minus x square minus y square equated to 0. If you equate it to 0, we get this expression. Similarly, if you equate the second to 0, we get this expression. When you solve it, when you are solving these expressions, you will get x is equal to y is equal to 1 by 3. 1 by 3 means x equal to 1 upon root 3, y is equal to 1 upon root 3, and z is also equal to 1 upon root 3. And this is a point, x, y, z, this is a center. Then we need to find Hessian matrix. The Hessian matrix, these derivatives, dou square f by dou x square, dou square f by dou x, dou y, and all these derivatives are calculated at this point, x equal to y is equal to z is equal to 1 upon root 3. These are the values. Now, when you solve this Hessian matrix, the value of this Hessian matrix is 256. Means that this determinant is 256. This is minus 32 by root 3. Now, you will see that this is negative and this is positive. That means we cannot say that this there is a maxima or whatever it is, but this Hessian matrix is positive and this is one minor is negative. This is negative at point at x equal to y is equal to z is equal to 1 upon root 3. So it gives us maximum maximum volume, and that is optimal solution. So the optimal solution is 8 upon 3 root 3. This is the optimal solution. If it is not clear, we can even see one more example, that how to discuss maxima or a minima in case of a function of 2 variables or maybe of a 3 variables. So you can take this example. Verify, find the maximum or minimum value of, find the maximum or minimum value of the function find the maximum and minimum value of the function shall we take function of 3 variable or 2 variable only? Okay, x plus 2y plus x plus 2y f is equal to x plus 2y plus xz minus, it is a function of 3 variable, xz minus x square minus y square minus z square, x square, y square, z square. This is a function of 3 variables. Now we need to check without constraint. This is with no constraint, non-linear but with no constraint. Now let us find with maximum or minimum values of this function. So let us calculate dou f by dou x. That is equal to 1 plus z minus 2x. Dou f by dou y. That is equal to 2 minus 2y. And dou f by dou z is equal to x minus 2z. Now if I say each is equal to 0. Oh sorry. This is actually okay. If I say each is equal to 0, what will I get? I will get y is equal to 1. Am I right? And I need to solve these two equations. So z 1 plus z minus 2x equal to 0 and x plus minus 2z is 0 minus 2z plus x equal to 0. Now we need to solve these two equations to get values of x and y. So how do we find values of x and y from this? So x is equal to 2z. So this will be minus 5z minus 4z. Z is equal to minus 1 by 4, correct? Z is equal to 1 by 4, is that right? Is it? This third equation will give me x is equal to 2z and I will put it in this equation. So this will be minus 4z, minus 1 by 3, minus 4z plus z is minus 3z, so it is 1 by 3. This is 1 by 3. And what about x then? X is equal to 2 by 3. So we could find values of x, y and z. Then you will consider dou square f by dou x square. What is that? Minus 2. Dou square f by dou y square. That is equal to minus 2. Dou square f by dou z square. That is equal to minus 2. Dou square f by dou x dou y. Equal to 0 because there is no value, no term in z. This. Dou square f by dou x dou z. Is equal to 1. Dou square f by dou x dou y dou z equal to 0. Dou square f by what is left? Dou x this is equal to 1. Dou square f by all are done.
Yes.
So we can create a Hessian matrix. So Hessian matrix H is equal to dou square f by dou x square, dou square f by dou x dou y. Dou square f by dou x dou z. Then dou square f by dou x dou y or dou y dou x. Dou square f by dou y square. Dou square f by dou y dou z. Then dou square f by dou z dou x. Dou z dou x. Dou square f by dou y dou z dou y and dou square f by dou z square. This is Hessian matrix. So you know how to put the values. then h will be, you know, dou square, this is minus 2, then 0 and 1, 0 and 1, this will be 0 minus 2, 0, 0 minus 2, 0, then it is 1, 0 minus 2. This is Hessian matrix. Now you can try finding their minors. Minors H1 is equal to minus 2. Minor H2 will be minus 2, 0. 0 minus 2, that is 4. And minor H3, principal minor H3, is equal to the matrix itself. And what is the value of that? Minus 2 into -4.
Minus 8.
Plus 1 into 2. So that is minus 6. Okay. The value is minus 6. So what is your conclusion? Oh, have I made some mistake? No. So what is your conclusion? So the signs of minors are, what are the signs? Negative, positive, and negative. Correct? Alternate. Is it right? That is, the signs are minus 1 raised to k. If you remember, I have explained it to you, HK. Okay, can I say this is positive? No, it is negative. Minus 1 raised to K, these are the signs. Positive, negative, positive, negative. So what is the conclusion? What is the conclusion?
Negative.
Positive, negative, negative, positive, negative. This is minus 1 raised to 1. This is minus 1 raised to 2. This is minus 1 raised to 3. Because the value is minus 2, 4, and minus 6. So this is minus 1 raised to 1. Minus 1 raised to 1 into HK. Means positive sign, and this is minus 1 raised to 2 HK. So these signs are all negative. So what do we conclude? Do you remember this? Do you remember? We have written that if the value of minus 1 raised to K into HK, principal minor of HK, if this has an alternate sign, then what do we say? This, there is a maxima. There is a maxima. And what is a maximum value? What is the maximum value? So what is the optimal solution? X is equal to 2 by 3, 1 by 3, and 1. So X is equal to 2 by 3. This is something different. Okay. X is equal to 2 by 3. Y is equal to 1. And Z is equal to 1 by 3. This will give us the optimal solution. Correct? So you can calculate F max. So you can calculate f max. Got it? What is the value of J F? What is the value of F? See, at one point we have written that minus 1 raised to k into hk. If this is positive for all values of k, then this is negative definite. And when it is negative definite, then there is a maxima. Maxima at this point 2 by 3, 1 and 1 by 3. So what is the maximum value of the function f max? You can calculate it by substituting x plus 2y plus xz. F max will be x means 2 by 3 plus 2y means 2 plus xz means 2 by 9. Minus x square means 4 by 9, minus y square is 1, and minus z square is 1 by 9. Now you can calculate the maximum value of this. So this will give me minus 1 by 3. This is minus 2 by 9 and minus 1 by 9. So minus 1 by 3. So it is
4 by 3.
4 by 3, maybe.
4 by 3, 4 by 3.
1 by 3 plus 1, this is 4 by 3. So the maximum value is 4 by 3. Got it? Okay. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now let us go ahead. How to solve this problem? One constraint now. Another method with a single constraint. This is a method known as a Lagrangian multiplier. Lagrangian multiplier, here I have directly written the example. Set two variables with one constraint. See, this is a function z is equal to 2x1 plus x2 plus 10, subject to the condition that x1 square plus 2x2 square is equal to 3, and we need to maximize it. Now, how do I maximize this function? So this L stands for Lagrangian function. This is a Lagrangian function. Capital X means a vector. Capital X is a vector, x1, x2. And lambda is a parameter known as a Lagrangian parameter. So this L is equal to, actually we write L as f x1 x2 plus lambda times g x1 x2, where f is an objective function and g is a constraint. This is a general practice of writing a function, Lagrange's function L, as f x1 x2 plus lambda times g x1 x2, and this is what is written here as L x lambda. So L x lambda will be 2x1 plus x2 plus 10 and plus 3 times the constant x, 3 minus x1 square minus x2 square. Now the necessary condition is, as again, the necessary condition is to solve this particular first order derivatives, equate this first order derivatives to 0. So I have taken the first order derivatives of all these functions, dl by dx1, dou l by dou x2, and dou l by dou lambda. So if I equate them to 0 and solve it, what we can find? We can find the values of lambda, x1, and x2. This lambda is equal to 2 because of first equation, and because of second equation, it is 1 by 8, x2 is 1 by 8, and x1 will be 190 by 64, and that comes out to be 2.97. So once we calculate these values, then we find the Hessian matrix. This is a sufficient condition in case of this Lagrange's method. There is no Hessian matrix, but this matrix or this determinant is to be calculated. This is a determinant, and this determinant is equal to 0. It will give us the sufficient condition for this Lagrange's method. Now, what is that determinant? What is L11, what is L22, what is L1n, and so on. Here, this is L11 minus Z, L12, L1n, G11, G21, Gm1, because there are m constraints and n variables. So L21, L22, and so on, Gm2. Likewise, we continue it, Ln1, Ln2, and Lnn, G1n, G2n, and Gmn. Here m is a number of constraints and n is a number of variable. M is less than n, or sometimes it might be greater than n. Then g11, g12, g1n, this is a determinant. This determinant equal to 0, it gives us a sufficient condition for maxima or a minima. Now, if you consider Lij, what is Lij? Means L11. Lij is defined as dou square L by dou xij dou xj. And gij is dou g by dou xj. Now see, for this example, how to calculate it. For this particular example, because we have a function of two variables only and only one constraint, so this determinant will become L11 minus Z, L12, G11, L21, L22 minus Z, and G12. Only this much, then G11 and G12, and last is 0. Now, how do I find this? How do I find L11, L12, L21, L22, and G11, G12? So L11, I have written LXY once again. This LXY is 2X1 plus X2 plus 10 plus lambda times 3 minus X1 square minus 2X2 square. And this bracket is nothing but G. So L11 means 1, 1. First variable is X, X1. So 1, 1 means dou square L by dou X1 square. This 1, 1 suffix represents X1, X1. This 1, 2 suffix means X1, X2. This 2, 2 suffix means X2, X2. So likewise, the suffixes are used to represent this determinant. So dou square L by dou X1 square will be dou by dou x of 2 minus lambda, because we know that first derivative is 2 minus lambda, so both are constant, so the derivative is 0. Whereas dou square L by dou x1 dou x2, here dou by dou x1 of dou L by dou x2, that is, you know, it is 1 minus 4x2 lambda, so if you differentiate it with respect to x1, it is still 0. Then the third one is dou square L by dou x2 square, that is dou by dou x2 of, again, same function. So this will give you 4 lambda, because the derivative of x2 with respect to x2 is 1. So it will give me 4 lambda, but I know lambda is equal to 2. So the value of this derivative is minus 8. Then we go to g. You know g is equal to, this is that function. G is equal to 3 minus x2, x1 square minus x2, 2x2 square. This is that function. Now when you take a derivative of this function, dou g by dou x will be what? Minus 2 lambda x. Am I right? X1. Minus 2 lambda x1. Is that correct? Minus 2 lambda x1. I made again a mistake here. So what is this? If I substitute the value, x1 is 190 by 64. So what is the value here? Minus 2 lambda x1. Minus 2 lambda x1. So what is it? Minus 2 into lambda is 2 into x1 is 190 by 64. So it is 190 by 16. Am I right? This will be 190 by 16. Of course, it is negative. This is 190 by 16. Then we go ahead. We can substitute. Now, similarly, we can calculate dou g by dou x2. Dou g by dou x2. Let us calculate dou g by dou x2. Dou g by dou x2. This is equal to minus 4 lambda x2. That is equal to minus 8 into x2 is 1 by 8. Am I right? So that will give me minus 1. Followed, it gives me minus 1. So next slide. So this is. So here, what is L22 means I will form this matrix. This is minus Z because L11 is 0. L12 is 0. This is minus 190 by 16. This is 0. This is minus 8 minus Z. This is minus 1. This is 190 minus 190 by 16. Minus 190 by 16. This is minus 1 and the last is 0. Now, if you evaluate this determinant, equate it to 0, you will get the value of Z. So how do I evaluate it? Minus Z into bracket 1 minus 1 plus 0 minus 190 by 16 into bracket 0 minus 190 by 16 into bracket 8 minus Z. This is that term. So it will be Z plus 190 square. 190 square upon 16 into 2, 32. Minus 190 square upon 16 square into Z. 190 square upon 16 square into Z and equal to 0. So this will give you the value of Z. Got it? This will give you the value of Z. one more example if you want. We will go ahead with one more example. How to solve it by Lagrangian multipliers. You can take this question that minimize z is equal to or f is equal to x square plus 1 minus 1 bracket square subject to 2 minus 2 x square plus y is equal to 4. Now we can use Lagrangian multiplier here. So what is my L? L x y x lambda is equal to f plus lambda g. Now how do I write it? It is x square plus y square minus 2y plus 1. I have opened this bracket plus lambda into bracket 4 plus 2x square minus y. This is my function f l x lambda. Now we will consider the necessary condition. So dou l by dou x. Dou l by dou x will give me 2x plus 4 lambda x. Am I right? Lambda into 2x square, the derivative is 4 lambda x. Dou l by dou y, this is equal to 0. So we can easily calculate x is equal to minus 2 lambda. Am I right? This is 2x will come out, sorry, 2x or lambda is equal to, let us see another one, dou l by dou y, this is equal to 2y minus 1, 2y minus 2, sorry, 2y minus 2 minus lambda equal to 0. And dou l by dou lambda is equal to 4 plus 2x square minus y equal to 0. Now we need to solve these three equations to find the values of x, lambda and y. So how to get it? Here we can say lambda is equal to 2y minus 2. Here we can say lambda is equal to 2x upon minus 2x upon 4x. Is that correct? Minus 2x upon 4x. So it will be minus half. So lambda is equal to minus half. So here we can find the value of y. Then minus half is equal to 2y minus 2. So y is equal to 3 by 4. Am I right? And x is equal to 2x square is equal to y minus 4. So that is 3 by 4 minus 4. So this will give me negative value. Am I right?
Thirteen by eight,
but it would be negative, na?
Yes, minus this 13 by 8.
Minus 13 by 8.
X square value is.
X square, so x is equal to I times root 13 by 8. So here we cannot find maxima or a minima because this is a complex root. So the domain is complex domain. So you can easily say that the function is neither maximum nor minimum because the domain is a complex domain. Right? The domain is a complex domain, hence there is neither maxima nor minima. You can say another one more example is there, that z is equal to x1 square plus x2 plus 1 bracket square plus x3 minus 1 bracket square subject to the condition is x1 plus 5x2 minus 3x3 is equal to 6. So what is your Lagrangian function? X1 square plus x2 square plus 2x2 plus 1 minus plus x3 square minus 2x3 plus 1 plus lambda times 6 minus x1 minus 5x2 plus 3x3. This is your function. Find first derivatives. Hello? Bolo. Haan, main kar rahi hoon. Kar rahi hoon, wahi kar rahi hoon. Jara lecture le rahi hoon, baad mein karte hoon. Okay, then we will calculate dou L by dou X1. What is it? 2X1 minus 6 minus lambda equal to 0. Dou L by dou X2 is equal to 2X2 plus 2 minus 5 lambda equal to 0. Then dou L by dou X3 will be 2x3, sorry, 2x3 minus 2 plus 3 lambda equal to 0. And dou L by dou lambda is equal to 6 minus x1 minus 5x2 plus 3x3 equal to 0. So you need to solve these four equations to find x1, x2, x3. What is lambda is equal to 2x1. First equation will give you lambda is equal to 2x1. So we can put it in all of them. So what this second equation will give me? It will give me 2x2 plus 2 minus 10x1 equal to 0. And third equation will give me 2x3 minus 2 plus 6x1 equal to 0. The fourth equation is still there, but can we find? This will give me x2 is equal to 10x1 minus 2 upon 2, that is 5x1 minus 1. This will be give me x3 is equal to minus 6x1 means minus 3x1 plus 1. So I know x2, x3 in terms of x1. So I can find x1 from the fourth equation. So the fourth equation will give me 6 minus x1 plus minus 5x2 means 25x1 plus 5 plus 3x3 means minus 9x1 plus 3 equal to 0. So how many x1 will be there? 35x1 is equal to 35x1 is equal to 14. So x1 will be 35 by 14. Sorry, 14 by 35.
It will be minus, madam.
How can it be minus? This is minus 35x1 plus 14 equal to 0. This is minus 35x1 minus 35x1 plus 14 equal to 0. So x1 will be 14 by 35. X2 will be 5x1 minus 1. So it is 5x1 means 14 by 35 means we can even simplify it as 2 by 7. Is it right? 2 by 5. Correct? X1 is 2 by 5. Y1 is 1. X2 is 1. X3 will be?
Minus 3x1 plus. Minus 3x plus 1.
Minus 3x1 plus 1. So minus 3 into 2 by 5 plus 1. That is equal to minus 6 by 5 plus 5 means minus 1 by 5. And lambda will be, lambda is equal to 2x1 means 4 by 5. So we got all the values. X1 is equal to 2 by 5. X2 is equal to 1. X3 is equal to minus 1 by 5. And lambda is equal to 4 by 5. We got all the four values. Now we need to find the second derivatives. Second order derivatives to check the signs. So dou square f by dou x1 square and Hessian matrix, that second order derivative and that determinant. What is second order derivative? This is 2, everywhere it is 2, 2, 2. Okay, 0, 0, and only last one will come. This is 2. This is same as dou square f upon dou x2 square. This is same as dou square f upon dou x3 square. Why is it so? If you look at this slide, previous slide, this is 2x1 minus lambda. This is 2x2 plus 2 minus 5 lambda. So the derivative is 2. This is also 2. Now combine derivatives with respect to x2. Dou square l by dou x1 x2 0. This is also 0 and this is also 0. All the derivatives will be 0. Second order derivatives. Which derivatives? Dou square f upon dou x dou y, dou x1 dou x2. This is 0. Dou square f upon dou x 2 dou x1 dou x3. This is also 0. Dou square f upon dou x 2 dou x3. This is also 0. All are 0. Each one is 2. Then what do we need? We need g. G is, you know, g is x 6 minus x1 plus 5x2. No, sorry, minus 5x2 plus 3x3. Am I right? This is your g. So dou g by dou x 1 is equal to minus 1. Dou g by dou x 2 is equal to minus 5. And dou g by dou x 3 is equal to 3. So all the derivatives are there. Then we can generate the determinant. What is that determinant? It is L11 minus Z, L12, L13, G11. Because we have only one constraint. L21, L22 minus Z, L23, G21. Then L31, L32, L33 minus Z, G31. Then G12, G22, G13, and this is 0. This is equal to 0. We have all these terms, right? This is the determinant. So now we can substitute the values here. We know all L11, L12, these are 2. So it is 2 minus Z. These are all zeros. G11, if you remember, G11 is minus 1, minus 5 and plus 3. This is minus 1, minus 5 and 3. I'm writing it here. This is 0. This is 2 minus Z. This is 0. This is 0, 0, 0, 2 minus Z, and this is minus 1, minus 5, and 3, and this is 0, equal to 0. So you know this is a 4x4 matrix. Solving this 4x4 determinant, solving this 4x4 determinant is little critical, but if you solve these two 3x3 determinants, you will get values. This is first one. And this determinant, then last is this into this determinant. Only two determinants are to be solved. So 2 minus Z, I need to solve this determinant. 2 minus Z, 0 minus 5, then 0, 2 minus Z, 3 minus 5, 3 and 0. So if I solve this determinant, this one, and one more we need to solve. So this is 2 minus Z into minus 9 minus 5 into 0 means 10 minus 5 Z. This is that first determinant. It can be, if you solve it, minus 18 minus 50. So it is minus 59 minus 68. This is minus 68 plus 25 plus 9. So that is 34x, 34z. This is that value of this determinant. Then one more determinant you need to solve. That is determinant 0, 2 minus z, 0. 0, 0, 2 minus z. And minus 1, minus 5, 3. If you solve it, only one term, 0 plus, so it is 2 minus z square. This will give you 2 minus z square. This is that determinant. We don't need to solve anything else. Then what is the value of this 4 by 4 determinant? The value of this 4 by 4 determinant is, this determinant is 2 minus z into minus 68 plus 34 z. Minus 0 plus 0. This is minus of minus 1 means plus 1 into this determinant, that is 2 minus z square. Bracket is equal to 0. Now if you solve this equation, you will get the optimum value of z. And this optimum value of z is obtained at the given points x1, x2, x3. And this comes out to be approximately what is given here, that is 28 by 5. I don't know whether it is right. You can cross check it. It is the answer given in the book. So this comes out to be 28 by 5. This is the value of z. Now this is minimum value of z because the question is of minima. Right? This is a Lagrangian method for finding the maxima or a minima. Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, miss.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. There are many things which can be taught to you. I have downloaded a book of, but that is in my college PC. I can show you that book, which is of course a very good book. And this is also one book, if you can see. Let me stop sharing so that you will be able to see this. If you see this book, this is Operational Research by Hira Gupta, by Prem Kumar Gupta and Hira. It's a very good book. Optimization is given in a very well, very good fashion in this book. And another book is by Sudhanshu Roy. Another book, this is that another book which is soft copy is available. You can easily download it. This is another book which you can see, which you can refer for engineering optimization. Theory and practice, Singirishu Rai, not Sudhanshu Rai, Singirishu Rai. Can you see this book? So whatever I have explained it to you, it is only from those two books.